Alright, YouTube, here we go again. One more video attacking one of life's great questions. What's the advantage of a low wing or a high wing? Which one is better for a starting student or an experienced pilot? So we're gonna go through the pros and the cons of each one. First of all, with the low wing, you will see that it has a greater dihedral. If you look at the wing, you see it picks up like that. That's the dihedral. That's to help the plane have a lateral stability, and it's more pronounced on the low wing. Now on the high wing, you see some dihedral, but it's not as pronounced. Why? Because the center of gravity, the weight of the aircraft, is actually below the wing, so it makes the plane more stable. Some aircraft with high wings also have quite a bit of pronounced dihedral, like the strutless, early strutless Cessna 210s. They have quite a pronounced dihedral. One other thing between the low wing and the high wing, most traffic patterns would be that you will be doing a left traffic, which means when you go to land, you will be turning towards the left, and your left wing will actually be blocking your view out the window as you're turning left. So when you look out the window, what you're gonna see is this left wing. Whereas on the low wing aircraft, when you're turning, let's say final, and you're looking at the runway, trying to see the runway, you will be able to see some of the runway because the wing is down and it's lower than where you are. Disadvantage of the low wing, when you have to sump the tank, you have to go underneath the wings, right there, to sump the tank. So for somebody who is going up there in age, that is a definite disadvantage. But on the plus side, when it's time to fuel, you come right here on top of the wing, you're standing on the ground, and you can easily refuel the tank. On the high wing, if it's time to sump, and I believe the sumps are underneath, but usually it shouldn't be a problem for the high wing, because you can, oh no, they're right here, sorry, my bad. I haven't had much experience with this aircraft, so it's right here, right underneath the wing, so you don't have to struggle too much to sump the tank, whereas there you have to crawl underneath the wing. When it comes to loading, unloading people, the winner is right here. Two doors, you can open both doors, you can be claustrophobic, you can come out of the plane easily. This one is kind of an exception. This is a Grumman, so to get into the aircraft, you have to climb on the wing, which means you have to be flexible enough to step up on this footwalk, and then you know, get into the aircraft. For the Pipers, the Cherokees especially, you have to do some kind of contortion work and getting through the lone door, which is usually on the starboard side. So on most of the single wing aircraft, from you have a single door right here, and that's how you get into the aircraft and out of the aircraft. The series, I also believe next thing we're gonna talk about, advantage, disadvantage. With the high wing, you can easily see the tie down is still on. So if you are in the aircraft, you've done your pre-flight and somehow you got distracted, you forgot the tie downs and they're still on, you can easily see this if you are with the high wing aircraft. The low wing aircraft, of course, you won't be able to see that it's underneath the wing. Removing the chocks, it's much more difficult on the low wing aircraft. You have to twist yourself, get underneath to remove the chocks. The aircraft, you just walk up there, you kick it off. If you're getting up there in age, like I said earlier, or you're handicapped, most handicapped people who are pilots, they fly like a Cessna Cardinal that doesn't have the strut bracing, which we see here. That's what they will fly. Disadvantage of the high wing, you can see, that's the fuel tank right there. So most people people having a bigger Cessna, single like this, they would have a little ladder in the back. And when they go to airports like this one right here, they would use the ladder to get up on the aircraft. That's a fruit farm right there. So, I believe they might have a ladder here, but it's not all the airports that have ladders. So you need to use the ladder, climb up, and fuel the aircraft. Cessna 152s, I believe you can't, 150s, 152s, you can't do it by yourself. But the 172s have a step somewhere here. You can hold somewhere here. So you can step and then hold here and then monkey yourself up and refuel the aircraft. What else did I have? Well, some people when flying, they find more comfort when they can actually see the wing. So it gives the impression that they are actually sitting on something, you know, that air cushion. So they like the lower wing aircraft, it gives them comfort. For some other people, you know, those doing photography and other stuff like that, they prefer the high wing. Operations in on improved strips, most people prefer the high wings because there, you know, you don't get to hit the bushes. It's clear of the bushes and other scrub you might have around. So it's very popular as a bush plane. You find them in Alaska, you find them in South America, you find them in Africa and other parts of the world where it's very difficult to have a mess if your aircraft is not flying more high wing aircraft. Low wing aircraft, they are more forgiving. They prefer to be in a more forgiving environment like here where you have a big strip and everything seems good. One more thing, these aircraft, the low wings are more prone to the ground effect. So you see most people who start out flying Cessnas, they go to a low wing aircraft, they will say no, it's easier to land. Well, if you misjudge and you know your approach speed, when you come close to the ground with the low wing aircraft, you will have that ground effect that will buffet the aircraft and you won't have that, you know, that big bounce. So some people actually prefer this after training because they say the low wing is easier to land. Well, the ground effect really helps a lot with that. High wing aircraft not so prone to the ground effect, but they also require like this, where we have a very blustery conditions, the high wing aircraft are more prone to roll over, to get blown over and tip. So the handling on the ground on windy days, where you have strong crosswinds, ground handling is very, very tricky with the high wing aircraft. Low wing aircraft, not so prone to high crosswinds and blustery conditions on the ground. And then the other thing you realize is the stance of the aircraft. You can see here how wide the wheels are, the gear, the landing gear on this aircraft. Actually, this is a very light aircraft. It's compared to that, it has just a tiny Lycoming 0235 engine with 108 horsepower. But you can see how wide the landing gear is. So it's usually very stable when you come into land. But the Cessnas, the high wing aircraft, they tend to have very, very narrow landing gear because of the fuselage. That's where the landing gear gets attached, and also they also tend to get very bouncy because most of the time they'll use steel springs, like the case on this 172. These are actually retractable gear, but as you can see, this is steel. So if you come in very hot and you slam it on the runway, it's gonna bounce you up, send you 20-30 feet in the air. So the other thing that I can add about high wing versus low wing is that with the high wing aircraft, you feel like you have more room, more space. So if you have your hangar, all this space below the aircraft, you can park a boat, you can park a classic car, whatever you have in your hangar is not wasted. Whereas in the low wing aircraft, pretty much all of that space is gone. You can't park anything. The utility of your hangar gets reduced really quick because that wing is in the way. If it's raining, you have a low wing aircraft like this, you land and you try to get out of the cockpit, you're gonna get it wet. Also, if it's raining, you can't get out without getting wet, so you'll be wet irrespective. With the high wing aircraft, of course, you can hide underneath the wing and walk in. You don't have water getting all over your cockpit, so that's a big, definite advantage. If you go out camping, air camping somewhere, you have a flying, it's easier to camp underneath the wing. You go to Oshkosh, you know, you can hide from the sun. The wing provides very good shade. That's another thing that the high wing trumps over the low wing. Low wing, there's nowhere to hide. You're exposed to the elements. If you see a few points that I may have missed, things I might have omitted in the high wing, low wing debate, a more relevant debate. All right, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.